Blue Man is sort of a mysterious outsider that enters our culture, seems to know a little bit about it, but not all about it, and gives us a chance to see it through fresh eyes.
We like to think of the Blue Man as a sort of an outsider from within.
We hope for the audience that they go into an experience of our shows and feel a sort of freedom, an openness, kind of to move beyond their daily practices or their, you know, the confines of the daily ways of thinking. No matter how many new instruments we kind of invent, it seems like we always will have a body of drums and tube instruments.
Some of the new instruments we designed for this record, one of them we call the clinulum. We've got
this instrument.
Yeah, we've got another instrument right here.
This metal ball, right?
That we're calling the spinulum.
The funny thing is, it sounds like a string instrument. It's melodic, but it's actually a percussion instrument because those zip ties that operate like spokes are continually kind of hitting the string. The one thing I get asked probably the most frequent question is, did I ever think Blue Man would become what you might consider successful or make my living from it, really? And the answer is always no, but I never would have imagined that we would have a lab like this, you know, and that we would be working with people who are like truly brilliant at inventing kind of technical gadgetry that, you know, no one else has thought of.
The unconventional layout of a PVC instrument that's not like a keyboard, that's not like a guitar, that's not like something that you've played a bunch of times, allows for things to fall under your hands in sort of a different way and makes you just compose different, you know? It's a new instrument that you just can't play muscle memory licks on, you know? There isn't really a big difference, I think, between visual arts or music making or whatever, or any other job. It's all just spontaneous openness to solving problems, you know?
Musically, it's fun to have a something that can do an unusual drone note, you know, and change chords. So, you know, it's also obviously something that the character can play. It's unusual, it's visual, we can project on it, we can make it glow, we can wash clothes, dry clothes.
For the Blue Man band members, this is one of the key instruments that the string players will use. As you can see, it's got many strings, and you play it with a glass slide, almost like a blues guitarist would.
Because each one of these things is a new, I mean, we thought of it, we have to make it, you know, we can't go off and buy the thing, then it's never finished. And that frustrates some of the operations people because they always want things to be locked down and done. But that's just not the best way to do it. The best way to do it is to keep making it better, I think.
Probably the theatrical part of it didn't really work. So it was a nice idea, and so a lot of a nice idea and a lot of work ends on your bench or behind your bench. This is essentially where we try to realize all the ideas that come from the upstairs, where it's all a concept. It's sort of the place where we stop questioning if it's possible or not.
I would say how many ideas actually get made? I don't know, 5% maybe, all the way.
This one has probably the most bizarre name of any of the instruments we have. It's called the big drum. We like to have ways that you see music, but we like to have ways that you feel it as well. It's that relentless, you know, kind of sledgehammer motion. It really does kind of evoke, you know, building a railroad or something like that.
The very first time we got together, we were sort of, all right, how do we take, you know, a stick and screw a Vaseline cup to it and hit a bucket of paint, and what does that sound like and look like? It looked a little better than it sounded, so we kept going. And so that's what we're doing now, because we're doing it with video suits and giant walking, you know, insect drums, and, you know, and it's not getting boring at all, and I don't think it is for the audience either. So I think we've got a great group of mad scientists, and as long as, you know, we can keep coming up with a moving experience for the audience, we hope to be doing that for years to come.